are the biggest challenges in the filmmaking industry?
The biggest challenge, I would like, this is more of a universal answer to my understanding of life for the short years I've been on Earth, is the biggest challenge to a human being is themselves. It's you who's the challenge. The moment you put that in the back of your mind every time you're about to make a decision or you're about to judge someone and say, wait a minute, what about if I'm taking this out of context? So we may claim the challenge to what's keeping us, I won't say Africans, but what's keeping the youth of this new, the younger generations we are going through now, what's keeping us poor or consistently lagging behind? We may blame it on no lack of money, we may blame it on no government support or whatsoever, but you can make it. In life, I believe this, how can I say this? For me, what my point is, I believe the biggest challenge to you is if you accept what life tells you. The moment life tells you, you're a girl, you can't do this. You never went to school, you can't do that. And you also sit back and say, yes, that they're right. That's when you'll fail. Because you have let something outside come and change what is on the inside of you. So the only way I would advise people is right now, change that question in your mindset of, instead of it being the biggest challenge to me achieving my goal, let's now start looking. What are those signs that are there to help you achieve your goal? Let's now start looking for the good signs that will help us move forward. So what are those signs? And for me, I'll use an example of Uganda. Some of the, rather than the challenges that I went through to become a filmmaker, what are the blessings I got in this country to become a filmmaker? The blessings are, I'm in a country where Ugandans have, they're so talented. We have been on projects before where you go in the village and you need an actor, someone to, an extra. You went with your cast, you've gone with your people from Kampala, you're rich in the village. And one thing that really happened to me was, there's a project we were filming, a commercial, and we left Kampala, we needed a village setting, and I had to drive deep in Mukono to find those grass, such houses. And we brought an actress, a young girl, to be the lead in one of the scenes in the village. The girl comes on set and she looks bougie, like her parents could afford to take her to a casting agency audition. So they give time to their daughter to get that exposure. So you would expect them to look after their daughter well, right? The problem is, in the village, we don't want a daughter who looks plump and chubby cheeks and all that. We needed a bit of texture, the picture to be all round. So the girl looked way better than she should. It took a long time for her to settle in and get into character. So we're stranded, we're running out of time. And in film, it's easier for us to film early in the morning and late in the afternoon. Around midday, it's quite harsh because the sun is overhead, it's quite bright. When you have that with these cameras, we are majorly designed to film white people. So when they film a brown person with this pigment on a really hot day with a lot of UV rays entering the lens, you look purple, ugly. The color of the person looks off. So it's always helpful to film very early in the morning or in the afternoon. Unless you have the budget to put a whole layer of material over you people to protect you from the direct sunlight. So we were stranded, we needed time, we were running out of time. So what we did is we ran to the neighborhood. There was a very young girl who was dressed in a white dress, you know, these white party dresses, but she's using it as her day dress, but it's like a party white dress, which was a little bit old. And she had this long natural hair, but it wasn't well kept, but it's beautifully long and brown. And she looked really beautiful. So we talked to her and she was young. This, I'm talking about a girl like this high, this tall. And we managed to interact with her. And in film, you're blessed in Uganda, very many locals, even if they've never known a camera, the moment they see a camera team and they're like, oh, so I have to act. What do I do? And all of a sudden you're like, oh, so we just need you mothers to pass talking your normal stories, carrying firewood. Don't look at the camera. Like, oh, easy. They do that naturally and it seamlessly falls in. So because of that, that's been one of those blessings. Uganda, the talent is too much. Then the next is the beauty. My country is beautiful. My country has, we have impenetrable forests, we have semi-arid deserts, we have mountains, we have valleys, we have lakes, salt lakes, fresh lakes, rivers, waterfalls, everything you nature calls for. Any animal that is in the savanna we have. So all those things are here to my benefit. I can be blessed to go on the streets and interview 3 or 4 people and make content and make money off it. So those are the blessings I've had. And I won't deny, unless you're talking about other challenges outside myself, I would say those challenges are more of the mindset of the person experiencing them. Quitting anyone, people say, oh, that person is successful. Bolt almost lost in his final years of career, of running career, but he managed to persevere. No, he still won because of who he, how he thinks of himself. So what you think of yourself is the only thing that matters. Not anything else in the room or in life. What you sleep at night and say, this is who I am, is who you are. And any time you look at yourself in the mirror, you may deny it, but what you may deny, you don't have to lie, because your life will always show it. The success you have, the poverty you have, the lack of friends, or all those, it comes from within and then it blossoms out. Depends on what garden you're planting your fruits in. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So basically, the biggest challenge is oneself. If they don't know how to work on themselves, let's say they have a second, I want to call it a second person within you.
Yeah.
That voice that always tells you, you can't do it.
Yeah.
You won't get there. So the biggest challenge is yourself or that other second person within you. So work on that and everything will be all right.
True.